Sync method number one is to manually sync your footage. And this is something that everybody should know because a lot of times when you rely on a computer to sync your footage, it can make some mistakes. And so you might need to go in and troubleshoot and you want to know how to do that. So to manually sync footage, we just stack it up in the timeline and then we want to make sure that we expand these tracks. So we do that by pressing the shift and the plus key. And that's going to let us see those audio waveforms because remember that's what we're using to sync is we're looking at the waveforms. And so I'm just going to look for a spike in the waveform where I clapped, or if you didn't clap, you can kind of just look for a similar pattern and we're just going to match those up. And now let's play this back to check our work. Let's talk about video gear because it can get out of control real quick. And that sounds good. My lips are moving at the right time, but the audio is doubled up because we need to delete that bad audio from our camera. So we'll select it and you'll notice when we do that, it's also got the video selected because remember the video and audio come out of your camera linked. So we're going to right click and select unlink and that's going to let us just select the audio and delete it. And now if we play this back, let's talk about video gear because it can get out of control real quick. Then things sound super profesh. So that is how you manually sync audio in Premiere. Now, if we want to be lazier than that, then we can use Premiere's built-in synchronization feature on the timeline. So here's how that works. First, you want to stack each of your recordings on a separate track on the timeline. So we've got a camera here that's focused on both of us. We've got a camera that's focused just on me, one that's focused just on Miles that did not have the audio levels on the camera set right. So hopefully that's not going to be a problem when we sync. And then we've also got a lav mic for each of us. So each recording is on a separate track. That's very important. I do not want Miles' lav audio on the same track as my lav audio. So it should look like this. And now I do not want to line all these waveforms up manually myself, and so to sync these, I am just going to select all these clips, I'm going to right click, and then I'm going to select synchronize. Now we're just going to give Premiere a minute to think, and voila, all our clips are synced just like that. So this synchronization feature is going to work well if you stop and start all the recordings on your different devices at about the same time. So if you're stopping and starting at different times, don't use this. You want to have nice, long, clean takes for this method. So like right here, it's very obvious that these clips go together and that these clips go together because unfortunately with this method, I need to sync each batch of recordings separately. If I try to select them all, then you'll see synchronize is grayed out. But if you only have a few batches of footage, you know, maybe you're just talking to the camera, then this synchronize function is really efficient. All right, sync method number three is the most efficient way to synchronize if you are just using one camera and one external audio recorder and it's not on the timeline, it is in the project panel. So here I've got some footage from an A-roll shoot. I've got my camera footage and then my audio footage. And so to sync these, I am going to select them. I'm going to right click and then I'm going to select create multi-camera source sequence. That is a long name and I know you're like, Mary, you just said that this is the method that you use if you're just using one camera and this says multi-camera and this is all very confusing. I know you can use this method to sync if you've got multiple cameras, but it is a hot mess and I would not recommend it. And so just think of multi-camera here as multi-device, right? You've got a camera and an audio recorder. So we're going to select this and then the settings window is going to come up. So in the first section where it says synchronize point, we're going to pick audio because we want Premiere to sync this footage based on the audio, based on points in the audio waveform. For the track channel, you want to select mix down. So audio mixing is when you mix different audio sources and mixing down is when you mix your audio down to just the good mic that you want. For sequence preset, you can leave that on automatic. You want to leave this check where it says move source clips to a process bin and I'm going to show you why that's important in a second. For sequence settings, choose camera one. For audio channels preset, leave that on automatic. And for camera names, you can leave that on the default, which is enumerate cameras or pick whatever you want. Okay, that was a lot of settings. Now we are going to click OK. Premiere is going to do its thing and it's done. Okay, so what just happened? Well, Premiere has put all the clips that it's processed in this bin here. And by process, we mean the clips that it has synced. And so thankfully, all of our footage here ended up in this process bin, which means Premiere could sync it. If you've got footage that has been left out in the cold and did not make it to this process bin, then your audio levels might have been off. Anyway, Premiere has also created these new items in our project panel that have this fancy new icon, and this is really exciting. So what are we going to do with these things? Well, we're just going to select them, and then we're going to drag them to an empty timeline panel so that they get added to a new sequence. But now if we look at this new sequence that we have just created, then you will see she looks really good and she sounds really good. So listen to this. This is the most efficient audio lesson ever. So we're only hearing the good audio, it's synced up with my mouth, and we didn't have to go through on the timeline and sync all of those batches of recording separately. It was just really efficient in the project panel. You've been watching an excerpt from the Big Video course, which is where I teach clueless beginners how to make videos like experts. You can learn more and you can watch a free preview of the course by visiting marybetsy.com/BVC or by clicking the link below.